Hi, this video is about functions in MATLAB. Functions are building blocks of programming, and it allows code to be generic and reusable. We design functions using the top-down approach, but we build it from the bottom up. What a function does is that it takes sets of inputs and perform a series of calculations on those inputs, or processes on those inputs, and return an output. This is a schematic diagram of a function. It takes an input, it could be 3, 4, or even 1 input and produces an output, which could also be one or more. In MATLAB, each function is a .m file. It is always good to name your .m file using the same name as the function name. For example, function name.m. What it looks in code is that it would have the word function with the out arguments equals to the function name and the in arguments. Let me show you how to create a function that calculates the cube of a number. To start off, we need to create a script or a .m file. We begin the function with the word function and the number of out arguments. In this case, we just like to see one out argument from this function. Y equals to the name of the function. Let's call it cube. And the in arguments. Since we only have one output, the in argument is one input, since we would like to calculate the cube of a number. Enter, go to the next line, and type in the equation. So the out argument is y, and we name the cube of the value to be as y equals to, how do we calculate the cube? Is just multiply the in argument 3 times in a row. And that's it. You have built a function. Now to run this function, you first need to save it. You need to name the .m file the same name as the function. MATLAB knows this and it automatically suggests that the function be named cube, which is the same name as the function. Save it. Now let's test the function. We can use the function by typing in the function, parenthesis, and the input, since we specify it to be just one input, we give one input into the function, let's say 3. Close the parenthesis and press enter, and it does as we want it, which is to calculate the cube of the number 3. Now let's add some help into this function so users can understand your functions. You can add help by adding in the comment symbol and typing the help after the comment symbols. You would like to describe the function as simply but comprehensively as possible. Since this is a simple function, I could just explain it in a line by typing in after finishing writing the help. I just need to save it. Potential users of this function can access the help documentation of this function by typing in the statement help with the name of the function, and it will display the comment section of that function. Now, what if you would like to calculate the cube of two numbers? So we need to increase the number of output, and we also need to increase the number of input. So to do that, we just add in more outputs and inputs into the function by using comma. Let's name the first output argument as y1 and the second argument output as y2. And also we need to add in the input arguments as x1 and x2. Now since we have two output and two inputs, we need to also calculate the output of the second input argument. So we change from y to y1, that needs to be reflected in this equation. y1 equals to x1 times x1 times x1. Oh, and we need to suppress the output. And the second output argument, which is y2, which is the cube of the second input, x2 times x2 times x2. After you're done with the function, save it. And let's test the function by typing in cube, the first argument in argument and the second in argument. And you will only see the first argument output. Now to see both arguments, you need to tell MATLAB that you expect two output arguments by using the square bracket. Let's say we like to put the first output argument into A and the second output argument into B equals to function cube 2, 3, and A and B, A is 8, which is the cube of 2, and B is 27, the cube of 3. Now what if you only input one argument but the function expects two in arguments? An arrow would show saying that there's not enough input arguments because it's not able to process the second line, y2 here. It limits the function because it requires the user to know how many input arguments is required. So we can make it more flexible by using the statement nargin, which stands for number of arguments in. So let's modify this function by adding this nargin. We type in if nargin is equals to 1, that means the number of argument is equals to 1, then run this. And designate y2 as not a number. Else if nargin is more than 1, or 2 in this case, then calculate the cube of y1. And calculate the cube of y2. Don't forget to end the if block and modify the help so that it reflects the actual process of the function. This is a function that calculates the cube of one or two numbers. Click on save and test run the function. So if cube 2, just one input argument, it'll calculate the cube of 2. And if it's 2, don't forget to tell MATLAB that you expect two outputs. So A, B equals to cube 2, 3. It still be able to calculate two input arguments as well as one input argument. Now let me introduce to you the statement return. We can use return to stop the function at the return statement to return the last value calculated. So if you don't like to use this else if block, then you can use the return function to stop the calculation at the number one input. So here, if I like to use the return function, the top part of the function is the same. If number of arguments is equals to one, then calculate the first input and return the second input to be not a number. You need to type in the statement return and then end. So what happens is that it will, if the number of arguments is 1, then it will go into this if block, calculate the cube of the first input argument, does not calculate the second because there's no second input argument, and return the results of the first input argument, and it would stop the operation of the function here. But if the number of arguments is not equals to 1, then it would calculate the cube of the first input argument and also the second input argument. Save it and let's test it. Cube 2, you calculate the cube of 2, and if there's two input arguments, it will also calculate the cube of the two input arguments. Instead of thinking of the input arguments as scalars, you can also think of them as vectors or an array of values. So let's rewrite this function, but expecting the input argument to be a vector or a matrix. So we start off just like before, function and the number of output arguments, but since we're dealing with matrices, then we can also expect that the output argument would be in a matrix format. So y, just like before, but now we expect this y to be matrix equals the name of the function and x. But now we expect x to also be in a matrix format. So far it still looks the same as the previous examples, but what's different here is that we calculate the cube as equals to x and the element by element exponentiation operator, which states that this x is any values within x will be exponentiated to the power of 3. And click on save to test this. So let's say cube for a 1 by 1 matrix input argument, cube to the cube of 2, you'll be able to calculate and display the results. But if it's more than one value, say 2, 3, 4, 5, 4 values, oops. Notice that I put a square bracket inside to show that the input argument is a matrix of 1 by 4 configuration. Press enter, and it will calculate each element in the matrix. Always don't forget to add in comments. I'll write here this function calculates the cube of a matrix of the elements of a matrix. And let's say the help statement is long and we like to keep it compressed as much as possible. It veers off until the end. What MATLAB does is that after crossing this line, it would automatically go to the next line and add a comment so that you can continue below. So we try to make the help of the comment section to be as minimal as possible, so it's easier for the user or the function to read the help section. So this is the end of this video about functions in MATLAB. Let me know your thoughts in the comment section below. Please like this video if you find it useful and subscribe to my channel if you want to see more instructional videos. I will see you in the next video. Bye.